I can't believe I'm doing this right now. What is going on? Hey everybody, what's up? My name is Gracie. I'm a 22-year-old lifestyle and travel vlogger. And let me tell you, as of 6 o'clock last night, I was not getting on this flight. And today, we are making the 24-hour journey from Palm Beach, Florida to Cape Town, South Africa. I am so excited about this trip. I am going on an 18-day cruise from South Africa to Dubai by myself. So we are going to solo travel as a female. And I can't wait to bring you guys along. Today, I'm going to bring you along on the flight. I'm not doing anything bougie. I am on Delta, but I am in the main cabin today. I'm gonna bring you along on my flights. First flight is to Atlanta. Second flight is from Atlanta to Johannesburg, but we aren't getting off the plane. From what I know, it's just like a fueling stop. And then from Johannesburg to Cape Town, this is the route that happens to go on Tuesday, which is not even the day I was originally supposed to go. Listen, it has been a wild ride, but I just can't wait to bring you on this solo journey. You guys can follow along on here. I'll also be posting on my Instagram and my TikTok, so make sure that you say subscribe down below and that you follow me on my other social medias to keep up with this solo adventure. I literally called Norwegian Cruise Line last night at 8 p.m. asking to go on the cruise that's in 3 days. I'm like, yep, I'm getting on the flight tomorrow. I had been pushing it off for so long, but yes, it's an 18-day cruise. Again, nothing fancy. I'm currently in an inside cabin, but I don't even care. I'm just so excited to go see 5 new African countries for me. Listen, this is gonna be the best thing ever. First of all, we gotta get there. It is 24 hours to get to Cape Town, South Africa. I think it's technically 23:45. So, you know, shaving off a little 15 minutes there, but truly like 24 hours to get there with the layovers and everything. So it's gonna be a long travel day. I put my hair in these little French braids to not have to deal with it. And so that maybe I can take them out and they'll still look okay in 24 hours. On top of that, I'm about to change into this cute little set from Amazon with some socks and some tennis shoes. I'm currently just in a totally other outfit because I don't wanna be in my plain outfit any longer than I need to be. That being said, I'm so happy you're here. Let's solo travel to South Africa. I can't believe this. Call me crazy, but I have 4 bags. I was only gonna have 3 and now I have 4. So what we've got is my travel backpack. This has got a lot of camera stuff in it, or it's gonna have more camera stuff like right around here. My nighttime bag, my Bible, my chargers. I've got my Kindle. I've got my sleep mask. I've got my laptop in there. And then I also have this Bays Weekender duffel bag. I got this for Christmas. I'm obsessed with it. It's pink. It matches my luggage. And inside of here, we've got a change of clothes. God forbid anything gets lost. Got a blanket in here. I've got my tripods on here. I've got so much camera gear, honestly, in this bag as well. I've also got my vitamins. I've got my whole makeup bag because nothing is over 3 ounces in there. I've got a speaker, some sunglasses, some chocolate, you know. So that's everything that's in this bag. And then I have this little carry-on suitcase, which I actually am gonna check. I get 3 checked bags, so I think that that's awesome. This bag just has like a packing cube and some sweatshirts and stuff in it. And then I have my big away suitcase, which is also going to get checked. I'm afraid it's going to be overweight, so we're gonna have to see about that. I have a small like fold-up duffel in here, so I could check 3 bags. That's what I get on Delta. But this has underwear, socks, bathing suits, clothes, my actual bathroom bag, cover-ups, hats. It's so much to think about, not only being on a cruise, but being in African islands and calculating for sea days and what to wear at night. I definitely don't have as many clothes to like wear on a cruise as I would like, but you know what? We're just gonna have to go with it. I'm gone for like 23 days. I cannot even believe this is still happening. So what I'm gonna do is get changed. My aunt and my grandpa are currently on their way. They're going to take me to the airport because my mom had a hair appointment today, and today was not the day I was supposed to fly out anyway. I was actually supposed to leave 2 days ago. Switched it to today because it's the last possible day to fly out, and somehow by the grace of God, it happened last night that I got the email. It's kind of a long story, but I'm going and they're gonna take me to the airport. So what I'm gonna do is get changed because they're on their way and get ready to head off to the Palm Beach International Airport to get on my flight to Atlanta. I already had to separate it into a third bag.
For a person you do not know, reporting suspicious personal activity to the nearby
Thank you. it to Atlanta with 2 hours and 15 minutes until my 16-hour flight. I'm currently in B and I need to get over to E, but my goal is to walk around as much as I can before getting on that flight because I'm gonna be sitting for so long over the next day. Just happy to be in Atlanta, even though this is one of my least favorite airports to connect in. Usually people don't know how to walk in this airport. It's always busy, but today it seems kind of mild, so thank goodness. So I'm on the flight. I have nobody in front of me. I picked one where it's two seats here on a three-seater, so I get all this legroom. This was included, at least with a Delta Medallion status. I didn't have to pay extra. This is just the main cabin. I'm so grateful. I can put my bag on the floor after we have takeoff. And I have two windows, which is just such the prettiest view right now. And 16 hours to go. Also, there's supposed to be somebody sitting here on the aisle, but nobody in the middle of us, which I'm praying that that's actually true because that would be really nice. Although, this exit seat armrest does not go down, so it doesn't even matter, but just a little bit of extra space. Although, I'm just mostly happy about this because I can get up and go pee or walk around whenever I want without having to bother anybody, which was the number one perk of picking this seat. I could not believe this seat was still available Saturday when I booked this flight. Like, I changed my flight from the Sunday flight to the Tuesday flight on Saturday, and this seat was still available. So, don't mind if I do.
Y'all, the boarding gates are closed, and nobody ended up sitting there.
I could cry. Two of them. She's like, you can just have both. That room was crowded or else I would have videoed this earlier, but basically we had to get off in Johannesburg for them to clean the plane, and now we're getting a new pilot, flight crew, all of that, and now we're heading back on to get to Cape Town. And also, I just got my outfit complimented by two ladies. I sent them the Amazon link. I was like, it's amazing. We're getting on our way. My big bag, and now we're just waiting for the other two.
I'm a whole PK, yeah.
Okay, one more. See it. Oh. Nice.
Not a problem.
We have made it to the hotel. Time to go check in. Hallelujah! I have made it to the hotel room. It is 9:30 at night. I can't even tell you what day it is, what time it feels like. I've lugged all my pieces of luggage in here. This is actually quite a spacious room. I booked this with my Chase points through Holiday Inn. This Holiday Inn had really great recommendations, and especially now that I'm only staying one night, this is perfect. Huge shower. I like this blue light. Only bummer is they have no food in this hotel except for breakfast. But she said that they, yes, here it is. A new thing through Uber Eats if I want to get dinner. And I'm not going to lie, guys, I'm pretty hungry. And all I have are protein bars or Hershey Kisses. So I feel like I should order myself chicken sandwich or something. We had dinner last night. On the way to Johannesburg, they gave us little sandwiches which I didn't really eat. And they gave us breakfast, which I had one piece of fruit, the yogurt, and the egg from the sandwich, and they gave us a chocolate. And other than that, when we were waiting to go from Johannesburg to Cape Town to get back on, we couldn't leave the little area. And they had chips and Twix over there, so that's kind of what I had, and a ton of water. So other than that, I've not really had a full real meal, so I think I'm gonna look on whatever Uber Eats this thing is. And I also really desperately need a shower. I stink, I feel like plain, I'm gonna get a great shower. Well, welcome to Cape Town. It's been a long 24 and a half hours since my first flight, so not even before leaving for the airport, so probably at this point 26 hours. I think it's the longest I've ever traveled. Seriously, oh my god. I need to figure out what I'm gonna get to eat, and I will catch up with you guys. I have chocolate in my mouth. I have showered, and look what came. Basically, right after the shower, I ordered a burger and fries from this place. I like literally know where to put you guys because I currently don't have my tripod. Okay, I got out my tripod so that we could do a little taste test. I'm just so grateful. They couldn't figure out how they paid, so I currently haven't even paid for this, but I think it's a little over $5. 123 rand, which I think is like $6. 123 rand is $7.18 for a burger and fries, and this company had a 4.8 star on Uber Eats, so let's see. Burger, fries, pretty good amount of fries. Here's the ketchup I asked for, this cool little container, and some napkins. I don't know if I'm starving or if these fries are just really good. Could be a little bit of both. Okay, I hope this is good. Oh my gosh, stamped ABC. 1, 2, 3, baby. Okay. Oh man, it's so good. Usually I really have to be in the mood for a burger, but when I was looking on there, it was pretty much pizza or burger places that were still open and were gonna be open by 10 o'clock. I was just hitting the spot. And while I'm eating, I'm just gonna do a little bit of work. I have like a video to upload and try and get up for you guys that I worked on the plane. And then I have another video that I worked on the plane that I'm almost finished with. Oh, I gotta connect to the internet. Teeth are brushed, contacts are out. I've got my sleep mask and my retainers, and I'm going to get to bed. I'm so exhausted. I just texted Brittany about something. He goes, how are you still up? Oh yeah, I guess it is 11:20 p.m. But I have been working on a couple of different things, so I just wanted to make sure that those are wrapped up while I had very reliable Wi-Fi. Sorry, the lighting in here kind of sucks right now. But I'm gonna put away my computer while I really cannot see without my contacts. Put away my computer and get to bed. I have no doubt that I will fall asleep so easily tonight. It's the side of the bed that I like to sleep on. I'm gonna get to bed. Good night.